Good morning, my little ones. So here I am back with a video on your picture composition. Now in my yesterday's video, I had asked you all to frame sentences, at least 5 sentences on your drawing room, right? I hope that you have done it and you have understood that how you will be framing the small sentences. I had told you the first point that sentences should be simple. The sentences should be short. And the sentences should be in the present tense. It can be used with a simple present or present continuous. So that means when I say present continuous or simple present, that means the action word, the action is going on if it is in continuous way. So these type of sentences when you use, I'm sure that you will be able to write a proper picture composition. Okay. So today now let us try our hand on a topic like let us go to the park, and let us again see how many sentences we can make about a park. Now you have an imagination with you about a park. In a park, what do we see? First of all, think about a park or a garden, that which you normally call that. In a garden you are going, in a park you are going, what do you see? So it's full of greenery, right? So you can say, what is that greenery? So the green grass is there, beautiful flowers are there. So let us write those small sentences, we'll frame them in. Okay, so here today I will not make the points, I will not write in points, because in picture composition we are not supposed to write in points, right? So today we will make it as a paragraph. Okay children, so here now let us see. This is a beautiful park. Okay, park is normally very beautiful, isn't it? So this is a beautiful park. Now I saw there, what do I see there? The green grass. Okay, so there is green grass everywhere, right? So let us write there, everywhere. Then you also must have seen beautiful flowers, isn't it? Colorful, colored flowers you must have seen, variety of flowers you must have seen, and you find it very lovely. So you can write there, I can see colorful flowers. Let us make it colorful flowers. You can also add on your own. It's not necessary that what I am writing, that only you will be writing. You can also add, I can see marigold flower, I can see dahlia flower. So you write on your own, but make it sure that my spelling should be right. Okay, so I should not write the wrong spellings, and so I'll try to take up the simple words, the spellings of which I know very well. So I'll pick up those simple words. Though I know that that is dahlia flower, I may not know the spelling. But once I learn the spelling, then it will be easy for me to write down, right? So here I can see colorful flowers. Now let us come to the park. What are the swings you see? Slides you see? You see many children playing over there. Then you can see even the ice cream vendor over there. So these are things also we can add up, right? So you can write, I can see the ice cream vendor . Okay, then you also play in the park, so come on, right? I play in the park. Now do you want to write, add up in that, I play in the park with my mother or with my brother, sister or friends? You can add up. Okay, I play in the park with my sister, or if you want to write brother and sister both, so you can make it siblings. Okay, So now you see how many sentences we have made? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. See, very simple ones we have made, but we have framed them on our own and then we have written. So at least 5 sentences we have done it on our own. So more you can write. So I played in the slide. Okay, I played in the slide. Now you see here I have used played. Now played is my past tense. Okay, so that is also right. So simple, by using the simple sentences I have started framing sentences, and now I have come to my past tense also. Okay, so I played in the slide, then I enjoyed playing in the park. Now you see how many sentences we have framed. Very simple ones we have framed, but at least we have framed so many sentences. I enjoyed playing in the park. So we all enjoy playing in the park. So this way, children, you can start framing small sentences. First you start with that, and then slowly you will be getting ideas, you will be developing those into long sentences, and I'm sure that you will get variety of sentences, because lot of ideas come to our mind. The only thing is that we should know it in words with the correct spellings to frame it into a grammatically correct sentence, right? So this way, once we are getting the ideas, and then one by one the flow of the ideas also come, and then we are able to write those. So the more you practice, the more better you will be getting into this picture composition. So children, today I would like to give you a homework to write at least 5 to 6 sentences on your park. Okay, so that the picture, you if you want, you can stick a picture of a park in your copy and then frame it on your own. Okay, so that will be your homework, and try to start with the simple sentences, and slowly as you get comfortable you can add up more and more of sentences. It's not necessary that you have to write only 5 sentences or 6 sentences because ma'am has told. No, you can write more of your sentences if you are correct in your grammar, of construction of the grammar in the sentence, as well as the spellings also should be right. Okay children, so thank you and have a wonderful day.